I can't help but think if we see a California or a San Francisco with no DoorDash, Uber, or Lyft, if they shut up shop altogether rather than give their employees, their drivers, employees status, the gig economy is going to take a major hit in the state. I know that this isn't your intention, but that may be the outcome. Are you concerned that California, San Francisco could become an undesirable place for other companies, particularly in the gig economy?
Good morning and great to be with you. Thanks for having me on. California and the Bay Area have always been home to innovation and to new technology, and they will continue to be so. But the reality here is we have companies that simply fail to comply with law as established by all three branches of government. And we are seeking to immediately require that DoorDash comply with state law. It's simply not a sustainable business model if they're unwilling to comply with state law. It's pretty straightforward. We need them to treat their employees as employees and provide them with all of the protections that employees receive by and from other companies. It's what the law requires, and they've had over a year to come into compliance with the law. They're actively trying to change the law. But if their business model doesn't allow them to comply with the law, then it's not a sustainable business model.
Do you agree with the Attorney General, then, that if they can't change their business model, they shouldn't be operating in San Francisco?
I hope that they will operate, but it's not fair to other companies and businesses that are operating. They're acting as though, because they use a smartphone and an application for their business model, labor laws don't apply to them. And that's simply not the case. Labor laws do apply to them, and their current business model not only cheats and puts their workers at risk, but it also cheats taxpayers and unfairly competes with other companies that are providing the same services and fully complying with the law. That is not acceptable, and we're not going to tolerate it. We welcome companies and innovation and gig companies that are willing to engage with their workforce and with other actors in their marketplace in a way that's on a level playing field, that abides by all of the same rules and regulations of every other company, and that treats their workers with dignity and respect.
Good morning, Mr. District Attorney. It's John Fort. I wonder, the strategy from Uber and Lyft, at least, seems to be to shut down temporarily ahead of November and then change the law so that they are in compliance with it. If they succeed in doing that, in showing people that they don't like an Uberless and Lyftless and maybe DoorDashless world, and the voters vote to change the law, will you be on their side then? Because then that will be the law.
Of course, we're enforcing the law as it exists, and we're not going to stand by and watch while major companies deprive California taxpayers of approximately $7 billion per year in payroll tax revenue. The law requires them to pay payroll tax. They're not doing it. If they change the law, then they change the law. But we are not going to allow them to simply choose not to comply with a law that every other employer in the state is complying with,
right?
Because they don't like it or because it is going to cost them money.
Well, I think
the law is
the
law, and they need to comply.
I think the companies would argue that there are all kinds of exceptions for which freelance-type workers or gig workers get to remain gig workers under this. And what I'm observing in this pandemic economy especially, freelance work is important. Consulting work, contractor work is important. Is the fundamental issue that there needs to be a mechanism for providing this segment of the workforce with benefits? Maybe it doesn't have to come from them being employees.
You're absolutely right that freelance work has its place, and we are in a new normal. You know what else is really important in this moment, in the midst of the pandemic, is unemployment benefits. And when companies like these systematically decline to pay their fair share, what we've seen in California and across the country is that state unemployment benefits have run out, and that the funds that corporations who are playing by the rules and abiding the law are paying into are totally depleted. And as a result, all of these folks who are actually employees for DoorDash and are now unemployed don't have the benefit of state insurance programs. That's unacceptable. That's why California passed AB 5, and they've had over a year to come into compliance. It's more than enough time for companies that are supposed to be at the cutting edge of technology and innovation. They know what the law is, and they're actively trying to change it. They can do that. They're allowed to do that. What they're not allowed to do, and what we will not tolerate in San Francisco, is them refusing to comply with the law simply because it would cost them money. the same money that every other employer in the state of California. Right.